Hey, this is Jamahl Kersey. I'm a criminal defense attorney in San Diego, California. And in this video, I want to talk about two things that I think make me stand out and make me different. So a lot of potential new clients actually find me here on this channel on YouTube. In addition, I have people that find me on Facebook, Instagram, LinkedIn, even on TikTok. With more and more information out there, potential new clients are being more and more informed when they contact me. There's just so much more information than there was 2, 5, 10 years ago. The two areas that I see a big difference between me and a lot of the attorneys that my potential clients have already consulted with are talks about money and caring. And so let's just start with the money talk. Listen, at the end of the day, this is not a nonprofit organization. People who call me know that I'm in private practice. I'm actually in the business of selling legal services. So there's no need for me to hit somebody in the mouth about, you know, my fees up front and talking about money. We will eventually get to that. And I think that's a huge difference between the experience that people get when they talk to me versus a lot of times I hear people who have interviewed a couple of attorneys and they felt like they were being rushed through the conversation and jumped straight to the money within 5 minutes of the conversation. And that just doesn't feel good. Listen, if you are facing criminal charges, this is one of the worst situations that could ever happen to you. I mean, really facing criminal charges and the prospect of potentially going to jail or prison or being hit with heavy fines is right up there with a major illness or a death of a family member. It can be that impactful for somebody. And so with that being said, the last thing you want is for you to be calling a professional and you're worried, you're scared, you're sad, you're frustrated, you're experiencing all these negative emotions. And the first thing they want to talk about is money. Listen, I just think that is completely lacking in emotional intelligence, which is a soft skill or a trait that is just as important as the technical skill of practicing law, the technical skills of being able to take a case to trial and put it in front of a jury. And I just think it's very insensitive for people to conduct their consultations in that way. And so that's something that I would never do. Before we even get to the money talk, we would have already spoken maybe 30, 40 minutes in. And then once I have been able to get an understanding of everything that's going on, all the issues that are relevant and pertinent to that particular client, because not every case is the same. They all have their specific hopes and needs, wants and desires, and those things need to be addressed accordingly. You can't just take a cookie cutter approach to a criminal case. And so that's why before I even get to talk about money, I need to know what actually is the problem. What is the issue here? Can I offer some sort of solution? Is there something that I can do that's actually going to add value to the situation? And then we're talking about numbers and everything. And obviously there needs to be a good fit. I don't take on every person who reaches out to me, even if they do have the money. So fortunately, I'm in a position where if I just don't think that we'll vibe, if I don't think that you're a right fit for our firm, or I don't think that our firm would be a good fit for you, then I just won't offer the service. And so it just makes things much better that way. But I really think it is very, very, very important to have a much more in-depth discussion about the facts of the case, about the client's wants, needs, desires, and really evaluating and assessing the fit before we're talking about money. And I think that first issue actually goes into the second issue, which is caring. I care a lot about my clients and I care about what I do. I'm in a very, very, very fortunate position in that I'm doing exactly what it is that I wanted to do. So I had a vision in my mind almost 20 years ago when I was in college, when I was 22 years old, I had visions of having a law firm. So I wasn't even in law school yet, but I knew I was going to go to law school. I wanted to become an attorney. I wanted to have a practice in which I was able to help people and really add value to people's lives. And I was going to have happy employees and interns, and whoever worked with us was going to really be able to see a marked difference between the way we did things and the way other people did things. And in large part, that has happened. I'm so blessed to be doing exactly what it is that I want to do. And so if you just think about in your own life, when you're doing something that you don't like, or, you know, something that you hate, it's so much harder to do a good job than when you're actually doing something that you like or that you love, that you're really passionate about. And so that's what what I bring to the table when it comes to the practice of law. I'm doing what it is that I love. This is something that I would do for free, and I have done for free. In limited situations, I will provide pro bono representation, but that's on a very limited basis. But practicing law, and this is what I tell people, if you can find something that you would do for free, that's the thing to do, because you're going to be able to approach that profession or that job with so much more enthusiasm than you will if you are forced to do it or you feel like you're being dragged into doing it. And so those two things I think are huge, because I just get people saying that they didn't feel like the person really cared about them, that they were just another number. When you compare that to my team, where we take steps to really make a person feel important, make them feel special, make them feel that they matter and they're not just a number, there's just a difference. There's really a difference that you can feel. And so these issues are in and of themselves important, but of course that does not replace actually doing a solid job for clients and getting results. At the end of the day, when people hire you, they're looking for someone to fight for them. They're looking for somebody who's experienced, who's knowledgeable, and who's ultimately going to put them in the best possible position for a favorable outcome. So I'm going to add one more, and that comes down to the promises that I hear that other attorneys are making to their clients. And this is just something that I feel is so irresponsible. When I hear someone tell me they spoke to another lawyer and that lawyer guaranteed them that they were going to make the case go away, they guaranteed that they were going to get charges dropped, they guaranteed all these different types of things. And for me, when I first have a consultation with somebody, the only thing I'm going by is what that person is telling me, whether it's their case or it's a girlfriend or a wife or a father or whoever's contacting me. 9 times out of 10, I will not have seen any police reports, witness statements, videos, photographs, any evidence whatsoever. So I'm very limited in terms of the opinion I can give as to how the case is going to play out. Now, once we're a little further down the line and I have all that information, I have all that evidence, I've had an opportunity to talk to my client, then I have a much better understanding in terms of what's going to happen. But early on, really, it just comes down to me letting the client know that, hey, I can't promise you any particular outcome because I can't predict the future. What I can say is that we are going to do everything that we can to put my client in the best possible position for a favorable outcome. And if that ends up being a dismissal, then great, that's wonderful. If it's something short of a dismissal where we're trying to either reduce the amount of time that my client is facing or reduce the seriousness of the charges from, say, a felony to a misdemeanor or a misdemeanor to an infraction or possible dismissal after a certain amount of time, then that's what we'll go for. But realistically, in terms of guaranteeing outcomes, I just really think that's unfair. I think it's irresponsible because you just don't know. And so for me, I just understand that clients are, you know, people will be reasonable with you. If you tell them, listen, we're going to do everything that we can without making any particular guarantees as to an outcome, if the person is reasonable, they're going to understand that. There is no need to make these lofty guarantees that the person knows that they have no idea whether they're going to be able to fulfill on that commitment or not. So boom, there you have it. Why I set myself apart, what makes me different, and why the experience at Kersey Law is different. If you made it this far, thanks so much for checking it out. If you got some value, please hit the like button. Make sure you're already subscribed. And until next time, peace.